Welcome to Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan. Thank you for watching. And now, I am about to play a deck I only barely understand against Lawler's Gate. It's Azorius Kitty. First, there was a kitty called Boros Kitty. And now there is another kitty called Azorius Kitty. This is a reality asset control deck. Much like the weird deck, but this one is built by the great David Schaffer. He has been playing it in tournaments, and I'm really tired. I've spent a lot of hours doing the Modern Masters review, and I can barely know what I'm doing. So this will be interesting, and I'm happy to run into a strange deck as well. I'm gonna have to discard here, that's gonna suck. Well, Spreading Seas would be awesome here. So what am I really discarding here? Is it the Drake? Or Spreading Seas? No, the Drake enables the Reality Acid. I think it's the Spreading Seas, actually. But that's just because I have another one. Uh-oh. It's an Orso deck. He's gonna extort me. But, no, it's a Pestilence deck! But his... Of course, his weakness here is the Basilica. Dreamstalker. Oh, this looks like a good plan. I'm pretty much just building up to Muldrifter here. Rift Watcher isn't very good against us. Pestilence will be horrible. But I think I'm just gonna... Oh, that's nice. Play Reality Acid on something. Possibly on the Signet. Yeah, I really think things through before I do them. And here's a Crossroads, and I'm done. Then I can Dreamstalk it and play it again. And here comes Pestilence. And Dreamstalker is pretty good at keeping Pestilence around. But we don't want to keep Pestilence around, do we? So we have to play the other Reality Acid. But it doesn't enchant. It doesn't enchant. Yeah, it does enchant Pestilence. I should be doing a ton of mistakes. So point them all out. I need to get that Reality Acid back, right? Oh, extort guy! We don't like extort guys, do we? So we destroy them. Even Rift Watcher leaves the field. Reality Acid is still around. So we can still save it. And we probably should. Now Rift Watcher doesn't do anything, so we're not afraid of that. It gives us time to be mid-range. No! It's gone. See how tired I am when I thought I could rescue that. Which, naturally, I could not. The guild gate, maybe? Is that what we want to do? Hobble Crossroads. Not too exciting, but let's get them. And he's like, Rift Watch is dying by itself. A Basilica! Oh, yeah, spreading seas, not too good. When that happens. Crossroads. He can save himself from the reality asset as well. Casting the Muldrifter. There is the stuff we need for a quick Basilica kill with Dreamstalker Reality Acid. Whoa! That's pretty good, but of course I have stuff to do against that. Such as Dreamstalker. And I will Dreamstalk the Muldrifter. And recast it. Grinding out value. And we're waiting until the field is clear here. And then we can journey to nowhere the Wall of Hope. Of course, he has a mass removal deck, so he can do a lot of hurt us. Hobble. Can't block if it's black. That's not very exciting. Okay. Let's go to town with the journeys. So taking out that guy. And the other guy. And then we are playing nothing. But we are playing something. We have 5 manas, we are playing a Muldrifter. And there is momentary blink. So next turn we can reality acid and blink stuff and kill his basilicas. So hopefully he doesn't play Pestilence now, but even if he does, my grip is full with broken cards. So I think I am overwhelming this Orzhov deck. And he should be looking at Grey Ghost, the Deluxe Course deck instead. Here comes Pestilence, can Pestilence for two. There's Wall of Hope as well. That's all he has. And it's really not enough at all. So we fetters it. We cast Rialto Acid. We Skyfisher Pestilence. Yeah, he's had enough of that. So what's in our sideboard here? Sanctifiers for Pestilence. How good is that? Curse of the Bloody Tome. The Pestilence deck should be like really vulnerable to that. What else are we really afraid of? So what's not good against Pestilence? Spreading Seas weren't that good. That sideboard probably sucks. But this is what I'm gonna try to do. One for wanting him with Journey to Nowhere didn't feel too bad either. I'm so tired, I already forgotten what I put in the deck. Curse of the Bloody Tome, yes! Let's try that! That's a crazy plan, but I think that the Pestilence deck has a really hard time to handle the curse. Because it doesn't kill very quickly. I might be totally wrong there. And I might be bringing... I might be giving him stuff he really wants from his graveyard. But I'm gonna try it. Please criticize me. I don't want to bring in the Sanctifiers because... he just has four Pestilences. And I can still destroy them. This is a keep. I'm interested in that I'm playing Face Feathers. What's the thing with that? Of course you can bounce it and gain 4 life. It's probably brilliant in the deck. Because most things they do. Oh, it's not a Guild Gate! Whoops. Okay. Whoa. God. I done that mistake in Grey Ghost as well. Well, let's give him some handicap. I discard a card. Well, I'm gonna keep them. And then I'm gonna discard next turn. Unless I can find white mana. But there's like no immediate threat from him. The Signets as well. He has the Signets. I'm discarding that island. What am I doing? Why? I am so tired. It's past midnight. Okay. From now on, I need something more to drink here. And from now on, I will like make good decisions. And not bad decisions. Okay, he's getting Pestilence. And I'm not playing my land. I play one land in three turns. Here's Guardian of the Guild Pact. He is fairly bad news for our deck. So let's ponder that. There were sanctifiers in my deck. Okay, they look pretty good. We don't want that, or do we? Yeah, we do it. So now I play that. To the land. And discard something. What do I discard? Probably face feathers. Fetters. And now I draw the Azorius Guildgate, right? Guardian of the Guild Pact is so slow, so I think I can like outdo it. I am discarding perfectly fine by myself here. I think I gotta drop the Dreamstalker. And an island. Guildgate. Preordain. So I'm gonna need one of these. No. Good. One white mana. So I'm gonna cast the Sanctifiers and get rid of the Signet next turn. But then he will lock me under Pestilence here. But of course, then I can just Sanctify the Pestilence. He's having the all land thing going on. Sanctifiers is next. Wow. Yeah, I've given him too much head start here, but now I have some value coming up here. I have to wait for Pestilence, right? And there's the island, I can't play it. I can play it next turn, unless I get Ravenscribed. Another Guardian of the Guild Pact is no good thing. I'm just impressed that I didn't try to play Journey to Nowhere and had to journey my own guy. Ponder Skyfisher. Can I raise this guy? It will be hard. Ooh. Card is just so good. Okay, it got harder to raise him. Skyfisher, Reality Acid. Planes. No, I don't want to shuffle it. I want to ponder again. I guess I won't. I'm sending this back. Like that. And then I'm playing Reality Acid on that thing. And I really have no hope here. I'm doing weird things. I should lose this duel. Sorry, Dave, for mishandling your deck this much. I'm staying up way too late. I promised somebody in a comment to play a deck game with Azorius Kitty. But I will come back to this next week and play better. Okay. Curse of the Bloody Tomb doesn't look so good now, does it? We should probably just concede here. No! No, no, no. Let's play it. We have one more turn to live. So how do we stop these guys? Yeah, we probably need something more relevant than Curse of the Bloody Tomb. Not dead yet, he can only do one damage. Yeah, let's forget this travesty of a game and move to the third duel. And take out Curse of the Bloody Tomb, because we are not gonna be able to defend. We got to grind him out. And it's the Sanctifiers that will do it. Not the Spreading Seas either. But they should probably either be sideboarded out or sideboarded in. Who is this guy? Playing first. We're taking a mulligan. We are keeping. I'm not sure what I'm trying to accomplish with my face feathers. But it did work out nicely in the first match. It's a way to gain life, I guess. Preordain. Crossroads Sanctifiers. Sounds pretty good. And go. Wall of Hope. Well. Take it to a journey to nowhere. And gain some life. Another Wall of Hope. Target and Sean McCarthy in your graveyard to the battlefield. Well, they're not there yet, are they? Okay, let's think about this. We want this guy. And then we want this guy. And then we want this guy. But we're missing a land drop here. So it wasn't a very good idea. But next time we're gonna draw the island and then we can sanctify. And that would be so much sweet value. that here's Guardian of the Guild Pact coming to spoil the day. So what do you do now? What do we do? Maybe we have to play... We play the Oromancer, so we have a clock. Equivalent to his clock. Unless he draw multiple guardians. This is where face feathers come in, right? That's also something we can... bounce. Do we really want to bounce face feathers? Okay, the activated ability clause did not apply. And now we are in trouble. So much trouble. Well, at least now we have Muldrifter mana next turn. But we are gonna take some damage. Riftwatcher Assault. Well, that's a lot of damage coming my way. I'm not scared yet. Just draw the cards, right? And next turn we can reality acid Dreamstalk the Basilica Guards. And now we can double block the right Rift Watcher. Maybe it's the Basilic actually. He's grinding me out now, pretty badly. Ooh. Well, we have been waiting for Pestilence. Oh, Patrician Scorn. Not bad. But we are not very afraid of Wall of Hope here. I still think it is the Basilica. Well, I would like to get rid of the Basilica Guards. Because they are doing a lot of work. Pre-rain. Putting the Chancery there. Putting Fate's Feather on top. Is that really what you want to do? And now, if he does use Patrician Scorn, which I don't even know if it's an instant or not, not much happens. Here we go. Pestilence for one. It does kill the Drake. And it pretty well stops my attack. And I need a land here. But of course I'm gonna get rid of Pestilence now. And I did get the land. So let's see what we can do. Pestilence is gone, and we fetter one of them. This is starting to look manageable, doesn't it? I am sure I made a ton of mistakes in this match. And if he has a second Pestilence, and of course now he really gained the advantage. Who the hell is you? Yeah. Okay, I'm crushed here. He had a lot of artifact removal. Probably you die from splash damage to hexproof. But I didn't think people were very scared of hexproof anymore. But I have nothing against Guardian of the Guild Pact, right? Who are you? You're 2-3. Wow. What is a guy to do? Maybe we need to ponder this. Skyfisher Reality Acid is pretty good. So putting this on top, this on top, this on top. Don't want to shuffle. We could just return the Muldrifter, but that doesn't do a whole lot, does it? Or we could. I was gonna save it because we could return. Oh, the wall doesn't fly. Yeah, we could return any of these guys. What would Oromancer get back? Fetters. Or Reality Acid. Oh. I don't know what I'm doing at this point. Getting rid of these threatening things. And we have begun some sort of air assault here with this guy. The ground is secure, but we do only have 3 turns to live. Patrician scorn. But that's pretty much what I want you to do, right? Okay, I got to return it. Doesn't accomplish anything, does it? Okay, now I need to draw something good. Wait a minute. Don't I have... No, I don't. Actually, I shouldn't play Flicker in this deck. It's a momentary blink, but I only owned one momentary blink. If he has a Pestilence in hand, this is over. Okay, thank you, I guess. Well, I can get the crossroads, but I don't get any life for it. I can't get rid of him. He has defeated me. I've lost to Pestilence. And that's just... just really sad. Well, at least I gave Azorius Kitty a try. I will give Azorius Kitty a try next week as well, when I'm less tired. Thank you for watching Magic Gathering Strat. I'm Dan.